lacking on materials on the other job, so we have come to this one. Now we are repointing the whole back elevation of this house. We are doing the side and gable end, and we are going to be repointing the back of the garage. So it's the back of the garage, this elevation, which we've already made a start on. You'll see some pictures in a minute. See how all this elevation's getting redone, all ground out to about 20 mil. And then this end and the gable. So yeah, a lot of pointing, but we're here, we're doing it. We've got the gazebo up, this weather's crap again. But yeah, we're doing it. Loving life. Oh, and that's end of play on our first day on this job. So yeah, like we said, we've got all that elevation, all this elevation to do, but without the tower scaffold coming. Tower scaffold next week, so we've literally just come here on the off chance for today. We've come from there down to the ground, onto there, gone underneath the window, back up to where we can reach safely. Tap reveal. And then down this pier, and we've started just coming around the corner. So yeah, that's where we're at. But yeah, plenty of repointing to do, that's for sure. But the old max vac that goes on the Makita grinder helps massively. So yeah, we will catch you back on this job. We might come here tomorrow, or we might come here Monday. Right, so we're back on the grinding out job, and came here this morning, and I don't know, I ground out a couple of square metres. Dean was using the mortar rake, but it was starting to blunt. It was an old one from another job, so just been and picked up these. Now, these are bloody brilliant. These basically, they go on the 4-inch grinder. They are a mortar rake, and they got like diamond bits on them. I've picked up a 6mm and an 8mm. 8mm is perfect for the bed joints, the 6mm is perfect for these perps because it's quite tight joints on this house. And then I'm going to be busting through just with a 4-inch grinder, normal blade with the MaxVac dust, a dust arrest extractor. So yeah, watch this space. So this is what we've been up to this morning. We've just moved on to the back of the garage elevation now, and I've ground it all out with the actual grinding blade on a 4-inch Makita grinder with the MaxVac Hoover system just to keep dust to minimal. Dean's now just going over what I've done, just delicately getting the nice, like getting the detail of the brick. So like the edges, like my grinder runs through, but it doesn't get all of it. So he's going through with a little mortar rake now, and just getting the bits that basically I miss with the grinder. And now I'll show you what we've done this morning. We have done all the stuff that we can reach safely, just being stood on the ground, the low areas along this side. So yeah, that is where we're at. Obviously yesterday you see us doing the low areas on the back of this elevation side this morning, and now we're going to concentrate and try and get this back of this garage ground out today, and that'd be another good day done. It gets us well into the job. And then we are going back to the garage build tomorrow. Now I've been told the materials are on site. So, oosh! Right, so it's a bit slow going on the back of this garage. Whatever mortar they used in this, they were definitely sharp sounding. And yeah, it is tough, very tough, but we're getting through it. It is slowed us down a little bit. We was going great guns this morning. Just up in this area here, I'm going to take the max back head off the grinder just to be able to get right into that bit. That's as far as we've got so far in the garage. But we carry on. But yeah, it's rock hard, and as you can just see, the face of the bricks on some of these are blowing, and that is because the muck is harder than the bricks. So when the moisture gets in there, it's got nowhere to go. After the clean out, you always have to just use a hose, and all the joints, just give them a good spray out. You'll get all the loose lab joints. It's quite an important part of the repointing process, because if you don't do this, you'll be trying to put fresh mortar in the joint and there'll be all loose debris in there, and it just won't bind as good. It won't be nice and clean. Yeah, things on the hose, giving everywhere a good spray down. We are back here next week now. Tower scaffold booked in for Wednesday, so probably come back here then. We're going to be on the garage job now. Now we've got materials. There's much to do. We've been a couple of days here just doing this. Good morning. You find me in Crowborough today. And I'm not on my own, but I'm not with Dean. Got my little girl with me today, my eldest. Give us a wave, Ava.
Hello.
Good girl. Suppose you can't wave when I've asked you to carry that round. but yeah, so we're here on the grinding out job. Now, tower's turned up, and me and Ava have brought the tower round. And all I've done is I've got 2.5 metre platforms. What I've done is I've set up a 5 metre run. So it just means, off of this height, I'll only be able to get that pier and that pier. But what I'm going to do is I'm not going to go up any higher until we've got Dean here, and we're basically two adults here. But what I'll do is I'll move it along. I'll be able to get to the top of window here, and then we'll play around the side. So yeah, we'll just see how we get on. But yeah. Oh, Tuesday morning. Hope everyone had a good Easter. I know I did. I've eaten so much food that I feel like a slob. But yeah, we're back Crowborough. Gonna start grinding out in a minute. We just set the tower up. We've gone up two gates high, second platform's up. Try and make it as safe as possible. Dean's just getting all the leads set up, and just getting the transformers like in the corners, and just in the corner of that platform. So we've got a full platform for us to stand on. We don't want to have everything everywhere up there. We just want to get it all nice and safe so there's no trip hazards. Yeah, and we're gonna come through at the upper level and see how far we can get. So yeah, we'll catch you in a little while, and hopefully we've made a bit of progress. So this morning we've come between the two windows, worked our way right across as far as we can get because of the steps. But basically, all that area through between the windows, between them windows, and we've just gone up. There's a like a brick pier up here, we've just gone up there. We're going to then move the tower and get in up this pier and up this pier, and then we'll end up having a set tower up on that higher patio area there, just to get the other end. But yeah, we're nearly there on the back of the house. So a little bit here at lower level just to finish off. Lovely. Right, so ground right up to the soffit now. This pier, this end is done, middle pier and the next pier is done, and then between both the windows is done. So yeah, this end, it's all done. We're going to be setting up now on that other little raised area and start thinking about grinding out through here. Now them three joints that you can see, someone previous, not that long ago, has put heli bars in those three joints, and they've done it all the way along. And there's been new window put in, and they put cavity trays over and then put new bricks in either side. But what I'll show you at some point is how crap of a job they did. This middle one especially, the bricks are like bowing right out. But for now, Dean's up there just spraying all the joints out. You can see how dirty that water's coming out of the joints. It's important that you get all the loose muck out of the joints. But yeah, we're gonna carry on, and jobs are good. And
we're rolling, and as you can hear, we are grinding out. Basically, this is what it's looking like before we start. See how it's all a bit hit and miss. That's where someone's put some heli bars in and just repointed. This is all a bit sandy. This has got a lot more sharp sand in it. It's a very pickety one. It's all pretty horrible. But basically what we're doing is, you know, I'm using the MacVac product on the grinder, which I'm then attaching to my Hoover. And then what I'm doing is I'm using the Hoover without the bag. So all that's happening is it's filling up this chamber. Yes, I have to keep scraping the filter out, but you try and use a bag, it just rips. So we're doing it without the bag. And then all we're doing is emptying the Hoover into a gorilla tub. We've been averaging a full gorilla tub's worth of mortar dust every day. So it's in the region of sort of about 15 to 17 square metres for grinding out a day. We've got 70 square metres to do. Yesterday was a bit of a shorter day. We got stopped by the rain. And as you can see, just check the eyes, we're wearing these. It's a hoods up, eye goggles on. It's not the most fun job in the world, but if you've got the right tools, like up there he's grinding out, you can't see much dust dropping. So it all goes in hoovers. It's perfect. But yeah, it's not the most fun job in the world. But we all do this game for the same reason. We're all going to pound nuggets. Yeah, just waiting for Dean to finish off that little area up there, and then we're both going to be down on this level, and we're going to be targeting from here, coming down, and down low is already done, so we've only got to get to here, and then we'll be set up on this upper patio area. We've had to do it a bit strange. We've got legs on the upper area and then legs on the lower area down there, which is all done by using the wheels. And the wheels on the tower, you've got like a star bit on a thread, and you can raise and lower the height. So we've managed to get it, even on uneven ground, right here, the raised patio is about 600 mil higher, so it's all good. Right, it's a lovely windy day, but busy on the grinders, grinding out. We're almost complete on the back elevation. See where they've put new cavity trays in and this new window. Wet bricks, those three quarters of wet bricks in there, and try joining it up when it's wet. It looks horrid. Same there. It's not very nice at all, but basically ground all the joints out. What you can see is all the staining on the bricks that they've left. Disgusting, but we've got to work with it now. We've got it all ground out, it's all going to get repointed. This area here, bloody hell, it's like grinding concrete. But we got there, you can see the colour difference. And we're just working our way down this pier now through under them windows. Heading off to Crowborough this morning. Lovely sunny day. Heading off to Crowborough. We're going to go and carry on grinding out. But first up, get a couple more blades. So we'll see you in a little while.
Time to go grinding.
New blades. Oh, yes. Glasses, gloves. Going to get a mask. Crackle.
All right. So that is the rear elevation all ground out. So we're around that side now. Oh yes, feel like we're getting somewhere.
Oh yeah, it's dusty. Voila, we're up at the gable. Almost there.
We are back at Crowborough. Oh, it feels good to be putting muck back in the wall, I'm telling you that. But basically, we've been up there in the sunshine, loving life. We've got the radio on. So yeah, we've the whole gable triangle is pointed and we are now about to drop that top platform. So we're just working off this middle platform now. And estimate we've done around 9 to 10 square meters already. So what time is it? I think it's about 11 ish just gone. We're just literally stopping for a drink and then yeah, we'll be carrying on. But yeah, so far so good. I hope you all had a lovely weekend and I hope everyone's out enjoying this sunshine. It's beautiful now. Long may it continue. Bit slack on the old camera today, but we've been pushing. So we've used one full gauge. Basically, we've gone from right up the gable all the way down this side. I don't know where you're going to see it because of the light. All the way up right into the soffit's done. So it just leaves tomorrow now from here to where the gate is up to basically the corner of that soffit up there. So we've just got to come down and you can see roughly where we've done in there.
So we've got a bit right up there coming down, and then it's this section, and then yeah, down to ground, and that's this whole elevation after that. We'll be coming around this corner and hitting the back elevation. I just wish this weather would stay with us. Yeah, we'll get this back elevation done. I reckon by the end of play Wednesday, this back elevation will be done. And then it leaves Thursday on the back of this garage here. We've got a little bit more grinding out to do on that. Yeah, we'll come to that tail end of the week. Hopefully Thursday we'll be on the back of the garage. That is my aim. It's just me and Dean. It's the two of us. It's a lot of pointing, but I think we can do it. I think we will. Keep tuned and you'll see whether it happens or not. Well, good morning. Just, it's nearly afternoon, nearly midday. I only really put that one story on of the mixer this morning. I'm just having a little walk up the road because that house there is the one we're doing. I want to see what it looks like from here. I'm going to try and spin the camera around because you get a better resolution. So maybe we can zoom in a bit. You can see where it's dried that we've done yesterday. And then this morning we've come down this side, come across, and we're actually down. We're almost at ground level. But where that's dried back, yeah, it looks smart. It's all filled in. All lovely. So yeah, jobs are good.
Morning all. Nice sunny morning. I'm out early. It's not even 7 o'clock and I'm sat outside yard wanting sand. I need to get some sand, so I'm gonna get loaded up and then we'll be heading off to Crowborough to carry on repointing. I've got to go and pick Dean up, and yeah, we're just gonna go and get, we want to try and get that rear elevation done, so we'll see how far we get today. Weather's on our side this week, so we can really push. Yeah, it's like Merchants is opening. I'm gonna get in there, get some sand, get loaded. We'll catch you when we get to Crowborough.
Right, so now we're at Crowborough. Got the sand, Dean's getting one in the mixer. We managed to, yesterday afternoon, start that pier up there coming down, and just above this window here. We've got to go slightly just above where this is. It's a bit awkward. We need to move that platform and get that area. But yeah, this is what we're targeting today. It's a big area, but we're going to go for it. See how far we get. Mine and Dean's guess is that we're going to get somewhere between these windows here. So that's a lot, but we'll see. So yeah, we're just going to push on. We'll catch you in a little bit.
A little sneak of this morning. Boom, flying.
Still a big area to go.
This has got 25% off food today.
Well, yeah.
So just give me the free bit. You're not going to lose out if I just eat the free bit.
Go on then.
Great. So that will be a bite of each sandwich and about 6 crisps.
This Friday at Costa Coffee, Costa Club members get 25% off food. It's that Friday feeling made a little better. Costa Coffee. Subject to availability.
Drinks apply to everyone, whether you're in a full-time, part-time, or a temporary role. These are different based on your age or whether you're doing an apprenticeship.
Yeah.
Don't just assume you're getting paid correctly. Check that you are and talk to your
employer.
To understand the new rates and to get advice, visit gov.uk/checkyourpay.
So now, we're going to pull the tower along. Go from here. Dean's going to do this bit here. I'm going to go up and do that bit up there. And then we'll work our way down here. Morning. We're here early doors. Dean's back on the Hawk.
We've got Smooth on the radio. This is yesterday's. Look how that's all dried back. Lovely. Shame about these three courses. This is what the bricks, this is a new window. And someone else put the window in, the lintel in, and then they put three course of brick over. They made a little bit of a mess of it. And when you look up, the bricks are actually... I can't really see it on there, but what's happening is the bricks going like that. They're actually like bellying out. But we ground out their muck because their jointing was horrible. Yeah, look at that. Wicked. Gonna crack on. Catch you in a little. Lovely. Look at this. Sun is shining. We've got that for our view right across the Ashdown Forest. It's beautiful. But yeah, all that is done. We've got a little area down here to do off the ground, which getting all the high areas. This bit we've come through under the window. So basically, we've got this pier to do, and just down there on that pier, and that's the back elevation boxed off. Oosh, we're almost there. That all the way up, that pier's done. It just leaves this little area here for tomorrow, and that'll be the back elevation complete. And then we've got to take that trellis off. We've got that bottom section and up that pier to grind out, and then repoint that. So it's a lot less pointing than what we've been doing every day, but there's loads of bricks to replace. Look at all these bricks, the spalled. Basically the face of them is all blown off. So, I mean, another two there, three there. Those ones over there, there's two on the back of the house. So, got bricks to replace. The garage and that other little area over there I just showed you to repoint. Plus we've got a wart seal.
Oh, good morning.
The weather has turned completely against us. But it's nice and it's dry now. But it has, on the plus side, brick guys understand this, the rain was dropping straight down. So it meant the wall weren't getting wet. Walls are still dry. Finished grinding out over there. Got that bit of trellis off. That's all ground out now. It's ready to point. Dean's just been finishing off this bit in here. Just this area down the bottom. I've been applying water seal, hence why it all looks wet. That is not, well, it is wet, but it's from water seal. Look at that. I've just got this lower area to do. I'm doing all the high areas for now because the tower is about to be collected. So yeah, gonna carry on. I've just got that end to water seal and then we can good to go. That's us done with the tower. It's all back on the drive, ready to off hire. All the water seals done. Beautiful. It's more like a cream, this stuff. Show you the box here. This storm dry. 25 year protection. And I tell you what, it's like a cream. It's not runny, it's really thick. You just apply it with a brush. Quality stuff. But it ain't cheap. But nothing is. Good stuff is never cheap. But yeah, the whole back elevation is all now water sealed. See, it goes on white. This is just where I finished off. I had a little bit just to patch in. You can see it all goes white and then it start drying back like this. All this is starting to take. But yeah, beautiful. Happy. All right, so we are, I didn't even know what the time is. Pushing on late Friday afternoon. Just basically got this corner and pier, centre pier from Sealite, and that pier from Sealite. Almost there, a little bit of the bottom there, of Dean's leg, but yeah, we're getting there. The house, all complete. Just needs a good tidy up. That's it. rear renovations all pointed in and finished, water sealed, gable end all ground out, pointed, water sealed, just had a massive clear up. And had a good old clean on the windows, and then yeah, the back of the garage. Pointed, but I've got to pop back here on Wednesday. I've got to just repair these bricks here. A few up in here, it's just the faces all blown, and then point them in, replace them, and then it's water sealed the garage, and then we're completely done. So it's just a little bit of titivating on the garage to do. Everywhere else is complete. So yeah, catch you on the next one.